Good morning. In this session, we will discuss about the sequence impedances and networks of three-phase synchronous generator. Let us consider a three-phase symmetrically wound alternator. The current flowing through the phase A is IA and current flowing through the phase B as IB and IC currents. Now, if we consider this system as a symmetrical system, all the self impedances are equal and the mutual impedances between the phases are also equal. Now, the symmetrically wound alternator is a perfectly a balanced system. And we know that for a balanced system, only the positive sequence components present. Similarly, this synchronous generator generates only the positive sequence components. That means, it produces only the positive sequence EMF. It will not produce the negative sequence and the zero sequence EMFs. Is this statement true? Let us check whether this statement is true or not. So for that, we are assuming the system is perfectly a balanced system. Now the sequence is ABC sequence. Now if you consider the EA is equal to EB, that is equal to EC. Let us consider voltage V, and now if you represent along with the angle, so you can say EA is equal to V at an angle 0 degrees and EB is equal to voltage V at an angle minus 120 degrees and EC is equal to V at an angle plus 120 degrees, or you can say V at an angle minus 240 degrees. Let us find the sequence components EA1, EA2 and the EA0 value. We know 1 by 3 times of EA plus A into EB plus A square EC. So that is equal to 1 by 3 times of EA is V plus A is 1 at an angle 120 degrees and EB is V at an angle minus 120 plus 1 at an angle 240 degrees. And EC is equal to, you can say 1 at an angle minus 240 or 1 at an angle plus 120 degrees. This will be equal to 1 by 3 times of V plus 120 minus 120 0 degrees, 1 at an angle 0. So now this also 1 at an angle 0 degrees. So finally you will get this value as a plus V and plus V, that is equal to V. So EA1 is equal to V volts. Similarly, let us find the EA2 and the EA0 values. EA2 is equal to 1 by 3 EA plus A square into EB plus A into EC. Now let us substitute the values. V plus A square is 1 at an angle 240 degrees into EB value is V at an angle minus 120 degrees plus 1 at an angle 120 degrees and EC value is 1 at an angle plus 120 degrees. That is equal to 1 by 3 times of V plus V at an angle 120 degrees and plus this is V value and V at an angle 240 degrees. So if you take V common from this, 1 by 3 V times of 1 plus minus 0.5 plus J0.866 plus 1 at an angle 240 degrees will give us minus 0.5 minus J0.866. So if you see here 1 minus 0.5 minus 0.5 will be 1. This will get cancelled. This 1 and these 2 minus 0.5s and plus J0.866 and minus J0.866. Finally, you will get 0 volts. Similarly, if you find out for EA0 is equal to 1 by 3 times of EA plus EB and plus EC. So that is equal to 1 by 3 times of, again V you can take common. So this is 1 plus 1 at an angle 120 minus 120 degrees plus 1 at an angle plus 120 degrees. Or you can say minus 240 degrees. So if you simplify, this also will be resulted into 0 volts. So therefore, from this derivation, positive sequence components alone induces the EMF. The negative sequence components and zero sequence components will not generate any induced EMFs. So whenever we are drawing the networks for the positive, negative and the zero sequence, only the positive sequence network will have the induced EMF. Negative and the zero sequence networks do not have any induced EMFs in the circuit. Now let us start with the positive, negative and the zero sequence components of the synchronous generator. For that, let us consider a three-phase equivalent circuit of synchronous generator. So always the stator windings of the synchronous generator will be symmetrically wound. So in a symmetrical system, all the phases will be perfectly in a balanced condition. So that is one point we should always remember with respect to the generator. Now the current carried by the phase A is equal to IA and phase B IB with respect to phase C IC. Now here you can consider two cases with respect to the neutral point. When the neutral current will be present and when the neutral current will be absent means. So let us consider case 1. When the generator is delivering a balanced load. So one is, this is a source. Obviously the source will be connected to the load terminals. So whatever the load that we are going to connect at these terminals, if that load is perfectly balanced, then there will not be any neutral current in the system. So in that case, the IN value will be equal to 0. That is the first condition. Second condition, if it is a fault, during which type of fault there won't be any neutral current means, if it is a symmetrical fault, then there won't be any neutral current. Because of the symmetrical fault, there won't be any unbalanced in the system. The current magnitudes may rise, but still the system will be under the balanced condition. So therefore, in those conditions, the neutral current IN will be 0. So there won't be any current flowing through this neutral connection. What is the second case? When the generator is delivering an unbalanced load. Now if you consider the same circuit under unbalanced load condition, so whatever we are going to consider, connect the load, if this load is an unbalanced load, then there will be some neutral currents in the system. Similarly, unsymmetrical fault condition. What are the unsymmetrical faults? We know all the shunt faults are the unsymmetrical fault except the three phase. So neutral current IN flows from the ground to the neutral point. Now let us draw the positive sequence network of the synchronous generator. We know the synchronous generator is wound with the symmetrical windings. I am going to draw the positive sequence plus this is the EA plus minus. Either you connect all the positive terminals or either you connect all the negative terminals. Don't connect one positive and one negative terminal. So plus EB and this is C voltage. Let us consider all the impedances as Z1. This is called the positive sequence network of the synchronous generator. I am not considering the neutral line here because the positive sequence components will not flow through the neutral line. And let us consider this is phase A, B and the C. IA current, IB current and IC current. So this is the positive sequence network with respect to the three phases. While doing analysis, should we consider all these three phases into the account or any other simplification method is available means, since we are assuming this system is a symmetrical system, the symmetrical system always it is a balanced system. Now, since the system is a balanced system, we have seen already while doing the symmetrical component, symmetrical fault analysis, instead of the three phases, we can take any one phase and perform the analysis, which will be equal for the, which will be same for the other two phases also. So this technique is applicable here also because the synchronous generator is under balanced condition. So now simply you can represent the positive sequence network of the synchronous generator as positive sequence impedance which is connected with the positive sequence EMF. And the current flowing through the circuit will be IA1. Now let us consider any phase, phase A to neutral or phase B to neutral, C to neutral, anything you can pick. So now I have taken with respect to the phase A, now the terminal voltage will be VA1. Now we know we have derived already the equations for the positive, negative and the zero sequence in the last class itself. So we know the positive, if you apply the KVL to this loop, then the positive sequence voltage VA1 is equal to the input voltage minus the drop. The drop will be minus IA1 into Z1. So this is the equation for the positive sequence network. Now we know this is the induced EMF of the generator and there is the current flowing through the circuit. What is the value of the positive sequence impedance of the generator? The positive sequence impedance is nothing but we have three states during the faulty condition. One is the subtransient period. Second one is the transient steady state period. So we will be doing analysis. Either you can take that as a subtransient, either you can take transient or the steady state condition. Most of the times the fault analysis will be carried out during this subtransient period. However, we have a three states, we have a three different reactances, that is the direct axis subtransient reactance XT double dash and the transient reactance and the steady state reactance XT. So during whichever condition that we are going to perform the analysis, this Z1 value will be equal to that respective reactance. So this is how you can get the value of positive sequence impedance of the synchronous generator. Now we have seen the negative sequence components do not cause any induced EMF in the synchronous generator. Because of the fault, the negative sequence currents flow in the generator, but it will not produce any induced EMF. So the negative sequence impedances are represented by only the negative sequence impedances. We won't be having any EMF here. So all the three phases you can represent the negative sequence impedance. So these are ABC phases. Now similarly, all the phases, the negative sequence impedance is same. Since it is a symmetrical systems will be underbalanced. So for a balanced system, instead of all the three phases, you can consider any one phase for the analysis. So what we can do, either you can select A phase, B phase or the C phase. Now what about the neutral connection? So should we consider a neutral connection? Should we ground this neutral point? Means not required. Why? Because we know that the negative sequence currents also do not flow through the neutral point. So we no need to consider the neutral point in this condition also. So now what will be the circuit? Like however we have represented positive sequence, here we will have only the negative sequence and we won't be having any induced EMF. So circuit is very simple. So VA2 and the current will be IA2 will be flowing through the circuit. If you apply the KVL to this, since we don't have any input here, the output voltage VA2 is equal to 0 volts minus IA2 into Z2. So finally you can represent VA2 is equal to minus IA2 into Z2 value. So this is the equation for the negative sequence terminal voltage. Now what about the value of the negative sequence impedance Z2 value with respect to the synchronous generator? We know this negative sequence will be opposite direction to the positive sequence. Yes or no? If I consider the positive sequence as a ABC, then the negative sequence will be represented by ACB. During the positive sequence, if the current flowing in this direction, means in the negative sequence, the current will flow in the opposite direction. With the flow of negative sequence currents in the stator, it develops a rotating field which is opposite directions to the positive sequence field. What will happen now? The flux will decrease. So whenever the flux decreases here, Rotating magnetic field will decrease. Field will decrease means flux will decrease. The relation between the speed and the flux will be inversely proportional. If flux decreases and the speed will increases. So the rotating field which is developed by the negative sequences rotates at a double the synchronous speed with respect to the rotor. Therefore, the currents at the double the stator frequency are induced in the rotor field as well as the damper windings. So therefore, the negative sequence MMF alternatively present with the reluctance of the direct as well as the quadrature axis. So finally, the negative sequence component can be represented by the XD double dash plus XQ double dash by 2. So this is about the negative sequence impedance of the circuit. Now coming to the zero sequence network of the synchronous generator, here also zero sequence components does not cause any induced EMF in the synchronous generator. So now we no need to represent the source here also. So the negative sequence network will have only Z0 value. Now look at here, instead of the Z0, I will represent this as a ZG0. So ZG0. So why I have represented like that, I will explain you now. So let us consider the ABC phases. Now in this circuit, whether we have to consider the neutral point or not, means we know that there is a strong relation between the zero sequence component and the neutral point. Wherever the neutral exists, there only the zero sequence components will exist. That means the zero sequence currents will flow through the neutral line. So therefore, the zero sequence network will have the neutral connected to the ground. So this is Zn value and this is neutral current In. Now similarly, if you consider, again this is a symmetrically owned system, so all the three phases are under balanced condition. So now for the analysis, we can consider only one phase instead of all the three phases, and let us consider this. Now what is the value of impedance here? In the last two cases, we have only the either positive sequence or the negative sequence. We don't have any neutral impedance. But here the neutral impedance is also present. Now I am representing this EMF as a Z0, the zero sequence impedance, and this is the zero sequence current IA0. Now what is the value of Z0? The Z0 value will have both the ZG0 value as well as the Zn value. What is the relation? How to consider that? Means we know this is the zero sequence component, right? So this is called IA0, IB0, IC0. ZG0 into IA0 plus there is a relation between the IA0 and the neutral current. So what is that relation? We know the voltage which is measured at this point, that is IN into ZN. So IN into ZN is the voltage with respect to the neutral line. But what is the current here? In terms of the IA0, if you want to represent, we know the current IA0 is equal to 1 by 3 times of IA plus IB plus IC. This quantity is nothing but neutral current, which is equal to IN by 3. So therefore, the current IN is equal to 3 times of IA0. If you substitute this relation in this equation, you will have 3 IA0 into Zn. Therefore, 3 times of Zn into IA0 is the voltage developed across this neutral. So this 3Zn to be considered into account while calculating this VA0 value. So that means this Z0 value is nothing but ZG0 plus 3 times of Zn. So very, very important. The zero sequence impedance is equal to ZG0 plus 3ZN. Now, we know the VA0 voltage is equal to minus IA0 into Z0. So this is the equation for negative sequence network. Coming to the case 1, if the neutral is solidly grounded. So now what is meant by a solidly grounded? So we know very well, if the neutral is dead short circuited with respect to the ground, this is called the solidly grounded system. So in this condition, what is the value of Zn? Since it is a short circuit, under short circuit any impedance will be zero. Either it is a resistance, reactance or the impedance will be zero. If Zn equal to zero, then what is the value of the Z0? Z0 will be equal to Zg0 plus 3Zn. We know where Zn is equal to zero, this will be equal to the Zg0 only. First condition. So that means if it is a solidly grounded, the 3Zn term will be completely zero. You can consider whatever the line, each phase impedance, that can be directly considered as a zero sequence impedance. Second case, case 2, if the neutral is ungrounded, so you will consider just a star connection which is not grounded. So in that case, Z0 will be equal to Zg0 plus, there is no connection means the neutral line is an open circuit. The neutral to the ground line is a open circuit. Wherever the open circuit is there the Zn value will be equal to infinity. So now, in place of 3Zn, if you substitute the infinite value, anything you add to the infinity will be equal to infinity. Infinite zero sequence impedance will be represented by a open circuit, that is the with respect to the neutral line. So this is a 3Zn, right? So that will be represented by open circuit. So this is VA0. Actually, the zero sequence network will be represented by this value is 3Zn, this value is Zg0, if the neutral is grounded through a reactance of Zn value, through a reactor of the impedance value Zn. Suppose, and this can be 3Xn also. So this is X0, Xg0 plus 3Xn. So the impedance, generally for any power system components, you will be considering the impedance. The resistance will be there but very small. So only the circuit is representing purely with the reactance value. Now, so solidly conditioned, case 1. Case 1 is solidly grounded. So in that case, this will be represented like this, Zg0, this is short circuit, and here we will have VA0. This is one circuit. Second condition is ungrounded. So the neutral is ungrounded, so there is no neutral present at all. In that condition, the 3Zn value will be open circuit. Here it is open circuit. This value is Zg0 and the VA0. So these are the actual sequence network representations for the zero sequence component. So I am representing here where Z0 is equal to Zg0 plus 3Zn. That's it.